In this episode of Minute GarageBand, we're going to show you how to set up and use multiple audio interfaces and USB mics for simultaneous multi-track recording. While it's possible to get a one or two channel interface to record audio at a relatively low cost, when you need 4, 8 or more channels, the cost of a single interface can grow rather quickly. GarageBand only accepts a single input device. However, OS X provides a solution by offering the tools to create a single virtual device. This virtual device can be made up of several low-cost input devices and is called an aggregate device, which GarageBand can use as its single input. To create an aggregate device, quit GarageBand, plug in all the interfaces and USB mics you intend to use, then open the Utilities folder on your Mac and launch the Audio MIDI Setup utility. This program will list all your current devices and allow quick and easy creation of the single virtual device from them. Click the plus sign icon and select Create Aggregate Device. Once created, you can double-click on the words Aggregate Device to name it and then press Return. Now we can choose which devices to add, and in this case, we're going to use the built-in line input for two channels, a LabTech USB mic for another channel, an iMic interface for two more channels, and finally a Personas FirePod for 10 more channels, giving us a total of 15 channels of input on our system. Back in GarageBand, open its preferences and select the Audio MIDI tab and choose our new aggregate device as input. This now gives us access to all the channels available from our various devices. In order to use them, enable multi-track recording and then assign each track either a single mono channel or a pair of channels for a stereo track. That's all we have for this episode. We hope you found it useful. And for more, subscribe to our YouTube channel. So long.
He says, I sent you a rowboat, an SUV, and a helicopter.